You're watching the Second News Hour debate on Times Now Super Prime Time.
Between the studios is TSR Subramaniam, former Cabinet Secretary. With us on the News Hour, Sunday News Hour debate is Shahid Siddiqui, Chief Editor of Nayi Duniya, understands Uttar Pradesh very well. Gaurav Bhatia, National President of the Legal Wing of the Samajwadi Party, on our live link today. Kamal Farooqi, Political Analyst. Jay Narayan Vyas of the BJP, GVL Narasimha Rao of the BJP, and CR Kesavan of the Congress Party. Firstly, to Jay Narayan Vyas and to GVL Narasimha Rao in succession, what really is your problem? You know, if the decision has been taken by the Election Commission, saying we inspected the case and he was not really doing anything wrong, what do you want him punished for? Mr. Jay Narayan Vyas, I'd like to go to you first.
Well, Arnab, I'd like to begin with where you ended introducing the subject. You gave the example of rally, which was not being permitted to Narendra Modi. It was permitted to others. Same place, same location, same considerations. Similar example is that of Kannauj magistrate. The Election Commission ordered the transfer of this fellow who has stayed there for long. The state administration did not act on it. Now, in a similar case in West Bengal, the Election Commission took a very strong stand, and the Chief Minister was to bow down before it. Third, you know, Azamgarh and Varanasi. Varanasi, they have put all paramilitary forces and everything, every booth. Fine, we welcome it. Why not similar arrangements in Azamgarh? So, issue is, Arnab, whether the law permits you to enter the polling booth
The law does not permit him. Mr. Kesavan, can you hear me now? The law does not permit him.
I can hear you.
The law does not permit him, but the two additional CEOs from UP who are the polling agents of the opposition parties present there, they had claimed that polling began only at 10:30 a.m. after Rahul Gandhi had left the booth. So anyway, Mr. Kesavan, regardless of all this, Rahul Gandhi has no business being inside the booth.
The issue,
he should be punished.
Simple issue.
If every leader walks into booth.
Simple issue. Simple.
Arnab, please read the handbook for presiding officers.
The law doesn't know this discretion.
It very clearly says who can enter the polling booth.
The law is
it says the candidate can enter the polling booth. The polling agent.
Just a minute. Mr. Vyas.
You are not permitted. Why are you there?
Mr. Vyas. Pertinent to note that Smriti Irani on the same day, May 7th, had defended her presence at the booth, something that Preeti Sahai, secretary of Priyanka Gandhi, had objected to. So the question is, if there was no polling going on at the time that Rahul Gandhi steps inside, how is he any different from Smriti Irani? And because Smriti Irani was outside, Rahul Gandhi was inside. But anyway, I don't want to go into those details. Fact is, Rahul Gandhi went in, he shouldn't have gone in, he should be punished. Why are you trying to
Arnab, please let us see the facts as clear as they are. It's crystal clear. The people who can go inside a polling booth, not the voting compartment, let me make it clear. Polling booths are candidates, polling agents and their relievers, besides the polling officers and the presiding officer. What happened was, there was a problem in the malfunctioning of the EVM, which Mr. Rahul Gandhi got to know. And that is what the report of the additional CEOs of UP say. So he got to the place, and you see what happened there.
Who is Rahul Gandhi to check the EVM? Mr. Kesavan makes absolutely no sense.
He's a candidate. Arnab, any candidate. Listen to me.
Just
any
a minute.
Candidate. I'm completing. Please let me. Arnab, I need to complete this. I'm speaking.
Mr. Kesavan, concede.
Arnab, I need to speak.
Engineer.
No, 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 not at all. Any candidate is allowed to go into the polling booth. Please understand that. Let me ask him to please wait for a second, sir. Let me complete, then you can make your statement.
Have to go and
No. Any candidate is allowed to go in. And let me ask you one thing, Arnab. Arnab, what were the polling agents? What were the polling agents of BJP?
Can I bring some order into the debate?
No, no. Let me ask.
Can I bring some order into the debate? Mr. Kesavan, listen to me. Listen to me, Mr. Kesavan. Even if my point is contrary to yours, please listen to me. Listen to me.
No, no. If you, sir, you allege a point. You allege, but I need to answer. You can't. Other people.
I'm not alleging. I'm making a point to you, Mr. Kesavan. Please listen to us.
I need to speak.
I know you need to speak, but I need to ask you the question, Mr. Kesavan. Please concede. My point is. My point is. Rahul Gandhi is not, first of all, some electronics engineer or EVM specialist. There is no compelling reason for Rahul Gandhi to enter a polling booth and check an EVM machine. Why should he have been inside the polling booth on election day in a constituency in which he was not voting? He had already cast his vote in New Delhi on the 10th of April. Had he or had he not? If he has cast his... No, 1 minute. Had he or had he not? He had. Concede it. Then he's wrong. Concede that. Don't be rigid about it just because he's your party vice president.
I'm not conceding nothing. I'm not conceding anything. I'm answering the question if you let us answer.
No.
Listen to this, Arnab.
When there was
a report of a failure of an EVM, he goes inside. No, no, let me ask you a question.
Why does he go inside? Is he from the Election Commission?
Inside the polling booth,
there is a problem, he has to report it to the presiding officer.
You had polling agents of AAP, polling agents of BSP. Why didn't they raise this issue with the presiding officer? The report doesn't say any problem, any
counter questions
raising an issue.
Come on,
counter views.
Why is it post facto? Why is
counter views coming in?
Why didn't the BJP raise?
No, 1 second. One minute. Please. I just want you to bear with me for a minute. Okay, I put those pictures out again.
Answer the question first.
No, Mr. Kesavan.
Why didn't the poll...
Mr. Kesavan, hear me. Okay? I put the pictures out. The pictures are behind me. And by the way, I want everyone involved in this debate right now. Gaurav Bhatia has been trying to come in. Mr. Kamal Farooqi has not spoken. TSR Subramaniam has not spoken.
He's a relieving agent. He's not a voter, by the way.
Sir,
he's a relieving agent.
Shahid Siddiqui wants to come in.
It is not a Congress party-controlled election. There are many other parties. If there is, you cannot have a single party representative going and inspecting EVM. If it has to happen, it has to happen in the presence of the presiding officer with all the polling agents present. You cannot. It's not a Congress party. I think this raises serious questions about the entire genuine election.
I have three questions. One, and I'm going to ask the question. Mr. Kesavan, please let me make a simple point. And my point is this, Shahid Siddiqui, I make a point.
The rules should be fair for everybody, Arnab. Rules should be fair for everybody. It should be a level playing ground. Everybody can't
exactly.
Say, you know, we can't be made to
keep that's what we are claiming. There are different set of rules that apply for you.
Are you going to listen to me?
The people of the country can see.
Gentlemen,
the entire polling machinery is saving Rahul Gandhi.
What's going on here? Mr. Kesavan and Mr. Rao, concede. Mr. Kesavan and Mr. Rao, please for a minute. Please just give me a minute. What's going on here on the news? I'm simply asking a question. Shahid Siddiqui, I ask a question. Why did Rahul Gandhi not seek the permission of the presiding officer before entering the polling booth? Simple question. What is he above the law?
Arnab, first of all, no inquiry was ordered by the Election Commission.
No. Every question is not for you. Lot of criticism came.
Only when they went for the... Yes.
I didn't answer, sir. I didn't say. I didn't utter a word.
Mr. Kesavan, listen to others also. Yes. If there was any problem, Mr. Rahul Gandhi could have made a complaint and the presiding officer, along with the agents of all other parties, could have gone and examined that machine. If he has done it alone, then that is a total, against the law, and action has to be taken against him, strict action, so that nobody does it again anywhere, because there are a lot of goons in a lot of constituencies. They will start doing that. Many of the candidates are criminals, and they will start entering and pressurizing the presiding officer, you know, playing with the machines. Rahul Gandhi has to be set up as an example for other candidates.
The question is, let's get Gaurav in, and let's get Gaurav in, and let's get Kamal Farooqi in. Mr. Kesavan, I know tonight that you are really on the back foot. I know that you are defending the indefensible.
Hardly.
And I know that heart of heart, you know that
why you have to shout and shout.
Not indefensible, but illegal.
But that should.
There was no balloting happening when this happened. There was no
Hindu. Mr. Kesavan,
how can it be a violation? There is
Mr. Kesavan, it is the Mr. Kesavan, please. Mr. Kesavan, 1 second. Gaurav Bhatia and Kamal Farooqi coming in, Mr. Kesavan.
What you're saying is what Churchill said. It's terminological inexactitude. It's terminological inexactitude.
Mr. Kesavan, a minute, please. Now, Mr. Kesavan, wait a minute. Gaurav Bhatia responding. Gaurav Bhatia. Gaurav Bhatia, please. 1-1. Yeah. Gaurav Bhatia is now responding.
Rahul Gandhi discovered that the machine, if Mr. Rahul Gandhi discovered that the EVM wasn't working, the right thing to do was approach the presiding officer over there, and then all the candidates should have been there before the EVM was inspected. The returning officer should have been informed.
Yes.
And an argument is being made by the Congress representative that at 10:30 Congress is making this argument that no votes had been casted at 10:30, and before that, let me tell them that at 8 o'clock the voting time starts, and it doesn't matter whether the votes have been cast or not. It after 8 o'clock no candidate can specially enter the designated area where the EVM is kept. It can be only done under the presence of the presiding officer with other candidates. It is a violation of Model Code of Conduct. And I would also add to this that the real test
for the Election
Commission of India is fair or not.
It's a violation of law. Shahid Siddiqui,
it's a violation of RPI.
Yes, it is not Model Code of Conduct. It's a violation of law. It's an illegal act.
Whether Election Commission of India...
Yes, and action has to be taken for that.
Just hear me out.
Arnab,
yes,
Arnab,
action. That is what I'm saying. The two tests would be whether the
answer.
Election
let
Commission of India was brought to act, and second, whether
Arnab,
the
Congress Vice President doesn't even know this basic law.
BSP,
he has no business to lead such a old party.
The polling agent of BSP raised it with the presiding officer. There was a presiding officer. There were three polling officers.
Blame the presiding officer.
If they think it's a violation, which is not,
it was raised. It was raised.
Not the polling agent. Now into the debate.
Keep me right.
Kamal Farooqi enters the debate.
Nothing was raised.
Gentlemen,
listen to me, sir. You look at the report of EC.
I want a minute of your attention.
No, you don't let me complete, Arnab. Arnab, you let everybody complete. You don't let me complete. That's not fair. It's not fair. This is not how we conduct the debate.
Mr. K7, everyone has to have their say, including others.
The beginning.
By the way,
Mr.
K7, hold it. I'm getting Kamal Farooqi in, and you listen to me because I'm letting Kamal Farooqi in. Kamal Farooqi, here now. Mr. Kamal Farooqi, here now. The Congress party blames the presiding officer in the election commission. Wonderful. I'm also asking you, why did the presiding officer not stop Mr. Rahul Gandhi? But is that the issue here? Mr. Kamal Farooqi will respond. Mr. Kesavan, don't speak out of turn. Mr. Kamal Farooqi, can they get away by blaming the presiding officer?
I don't think we should discuss all these things. Why? Because Election Commission has already taken note of all these kind of things. Do you think that the Election Commission is absolutely incompetent? Don't we have the confidence on them? They have already considered all these kind of things, and that's the reason they are saying it, that it is absolutely correct.
No,
if at all this is not correct, then there are other courses available to them.
Where is
the problem?
They didn't want even to go into any inquiry. They didn't want to take any action against Rahul. And that's why people are raising questions about the Election Commission and the Chief Election Commissioner.
One at a time. My question is, why is Rahul Gandhi being
spared? There's a lot which doesn't meet the eye.
Okay, we are 1 second. 1 minute. Gentlemen, please remember this, please. please remember this. This is what has happened. The picture here, once again. And I'm coming to you, Jayanarayan Vyas. Give me a minute. TSR Subramaniam has not spoken. This is what the picture is about. This is what the controversy is. 10:15 a.m., polling day. Rahul Gandhi enters a polling booth to inspect an EVM. I want to know what on earth was Rahul Gandhi inspecting? And if there was a fault, what on earth can Rahul Gandhi do anything about it? And on what basis was Rahul Gandhi inside? And if tomorrow, whether it's Narendra Modi or Mulayam Singh Yadav, they all go inside polling booths, it's a violation of the law. The Congress representative says the Election Commission has decided. I asked tonight, and as far as the law is concerned, Mrs. T.S.R. Subramaniam, I have the handbook to polling agents issued by the Election Commission, point number 46.1, which says every person is required to conduct himself in an orderly manner in and or near a polling station and to obey the directions of the presiding officer. Where was the presiding officer? Why did the presiding officer not stop Rahul Gandhi? Is that therefore not the fault of the Election Commission as well? And how do we conclude that in order to cover up that fault, they have also let Rahul Gandhi off the hook?
Arnab, I think two separate issues are here. One is a factual issue. I don't think there can be any question that Rahul entering the place of the EVM area is an offense.
Yeah.
I don't think we should discuss that.
Yeah.
Whether there was malafide or not, probably there was no malafide. Clearly there's a technical offense.
Doesn't matter.
Clearly there's a technical offense. Clearly he should have been pulled up. But I think it comes to a larger question. The EC, in my view, has highly underperformed in these elections.
Who?
I'm not the EC, Election Commission. I'm not sure. A number of things have happened here. They have not developed secondary channels. They have not shown their teeth from the beginning, allowed right from the beginning. In fact, they have allowed statements like blood will flow in the streets, Modi comes to power, etc. Which really, FIR should have gone straight away there. 3-4 statements came in the first week or two. And this is kind of akin to sort of direct action statement with Jinnah. That's the kind of statement it is. It is highly communally charged kind of a statement, should not have been allowed. I think the Election Commission lost the plot.
And this picture,
they lost the plot. They should have pulled up all these people at various times.
What was deliberate, or it was accidental that lost the plot?
Well.